Hello and welcome back to our Gaul Asia campaign. And at the moment we are merely just waiting for the right moment to start migrating. At the moment it's probably not the right time. It's cheaper, as I've said before, to migrate when your centralization is lower. So I'm thinking I just need to wait as long as possible and just like migrate everyone all at once. That would be fantastic. Gain 4 tyranny and imprison Drepes. I'd rather not do that, but I'd also rather not lose my popularity. He's the chief of the Galanis. He's only got 53 loyalty right now. Do you have an army? Not you. Yeah, it's you. I mean, 4 tyranny. What is it to execute? 2 tyranny. See you there. Gladiatorial debut against Mandonio Amidus. And he died. Well, sucks to be you. And also your army is just getting disbanded. Thank you very much. New bodyguard, let's get this guy in charge. Don't want either of those, and again, manpower recovery speed is the way to go. I have one pop of a different religion. They are... I can't quite see. I assume it's here? One of these guys is the wrong religion? Yeah, they're Iberic. But not for long. They are being converted quite happily. I think I will turn this away from culture conversion, and I will go with... Maybe acquisition of wealth? Or... Not sure. Manpower would be nice. Let's go with acquisition of wealth. That's probably the right choice. And again, we'll just keep waiting until I get lots and lots of lovely stability points. Getting tribesmen. These are entirely identical, but whatever. I could get some slaves or tribesmen. It's a pretty easy choice, really. Although, plus 2% pop growth is pretty nice, too. And that's for 30 years. Wow. In, where is it? Betere. Where is Betere? Betere. There it is. That's you. Your pop growth right now. So plus 2% isn't actually that much. Surplus of livestock and capital is 25%, for example. So yeah, actually I don't think that's, unless it's base. If it changes this to 5.99, then it'd totally be worth it. Nah, let's just get the 2 tribesmen. Also, you need to go stand somewhere you can sit without attrition. Like Narbo! Alright. You are being occupied by Aulerica. I guess you can't get here and you can't get here because nothing is changing. I think he might be my ally before too long. If he loses this land. Would not surprise me. I'm still at 24 cities. I can't get any more without becoming a larger power. But I like the size of my nation on the map. It's pretty good. I guess I do have these 4 wasteland provinces. So you can't really take all of it into account, but you know, whatever. Let's imprison the general of the second. And then immediately release him. For a 20 loyalty boost. And then I think I'll just pop him back in charge because he's fucking awesome. Unless I can't for some reason. 12 months have passed. Okay, well I'll wait because he's easily the best. Especially with being aggressive. So you can live without a leader for now. Maybe you can be assigned to region. Oh, did I just fuck up? I just immediately made them all loyal. Or immediately turned them all into retinue. I wonder. I bloody wonder right now. What happens if I do that again? No, nothing changes. Alright, soil. One time it worked, and the other time it didn't. Very, very odd. I have no idea what's going on there. But we'll just wait. It's only until, I think, February or something. I don't really need the army right now. Doesn't need to have the morale. Let's check it on low maintenance as well. And I am now allied with Lemovitzia. They lost all of this. You're new as well. I made you spit out this guy. I've now got too many relations, though. So, I think, Emporion, it's time for you to go. Let's dissolve that alliance. And we're back to being good. Price expansion coming down. There's a lot of tyranny. Be nice if... it only changes by 0.01. Oh god, that's terrible. That's actually really bad. Far too much tyranny. And now Lemovitzia is involved in a war against Viviscia, who is rather large. Who started this? Lemovitzia attacked Biturgia. Why would you do that? Also, Biturgia is not even in the war. Also, you are really large now. It looks like you have more cities than you actually do. But he's definitely going to have more cities when he gets this. For sure. How old am I? I'm 56. I kind of wouldn't mind him dying. Friends across borders. I could spend 25 ducats to get Narbonensis to like us a bit more. No thank you. I'm quite happy not being your friend. We'll put Salatus back in charge. 52 loyalty is not super high. Let's corrupt ourselves just a little bit. I would like to bribe him, get him super loyal. Oops, something happened there and then immediately went away. Negative 52 centralization. Is there any laws I can now pass? Yes, we've got oral traditions, assimilation speed, or we can go with primary culture happiness. I'm going to go with oral tradition. Lose some more centralization. And then we've only got one more left. So at the moment we're on manpower recovery speed. This one would be enslavement efficiency and slave output. This would be morale of armies and monthly war exhaustion. I kind of actually like what we're on right now. None of them change my centralization after all, so screw it. Disagreement on the highest level. I think this is fine. Yes, just side with Camarcus. You're pretty much dead. I don't think you're gonna survive this. None of your friends are involved in your war. So, yeah, 100% dead. This is your only army. And it is... he just lost the battle. Wherever he retreats to, he's probably gonna die. Ooh, sucks for him to be retreating south as well. You've just died, but you were terrible anyway. In 5 popularity. So my magistrate wouldn't like it very much. But are you gaining loyalty? Not really. You're also not losing it, so that's fine. And I need a new arbitrator. You're a fine fellow, you can do the job. Yeah, it looks like I'm going to have a border with Viviscia, which actually wouldn't be too bad. I could immediately attack Viviscia, as he would lose all of his allies. He's at 20 cities, he's certainly going to take more than 5. He'll have no allies, and we could just, me and Auskia, go and just murder him. Release Lemovitzia from it. Ooh, plus 10% national manpower, hell yes, perfect. Oh yeah, Lemovitzia is actually... pulling it back a little bit. I don't know how. Become the friend with Auskia. No, thank you. Thanks for the popularity, though. Yeah, he's just won two battles in succession. Three battles. He's gonna win another one? He did. Wow. And another one. That is super surprising. Do you have mercenaries by any chance? Employed. No. Wow, very interesting. There may even be a white piece here. Become friends with the tribal chieftain of Bigoronia, my vassal. No, thank you. Thanks for the popularity, though. Perfectly happy with that. Let's stab another pig. Oh, yeah, I'm very surprised that he's actually winning, and he's pushing him back, and he's actually sieging things. What is this madness? Loyalty from you. I mean, fine, it's whatever. I'm sure that won't come to bite me in the ass. I think I am going to wait until I got negative 100. I mean, it's going down super, super fast now. Negative 0.25 a month. That's really good. Obviously, the lower it is as well, clan retinues get larger, which is phenomenal. Tribes and output as well goes up. I like that. I have another bit of manpower recovery speed. Manpower at the moment is 44,000. We've only got 10k of it. Information on this guy. Sucks to be you. Ooh, are we finally pushed back too far? Maybe. I mean, there's 10,000 Limovitians coming in here. Go, Limovitia! You can do it! Yeah, I mean, heavy cav. No wonder. But they do have a lot of troops around here. Inspirational neighbor. No, I do not want some centralization, thank you very much. Who wants to live in cities anyway? Right? We just live in the forest. Oh! Limovitia. One. They absolutely just demolished him. Look at that! I was expecting Limovitia to get annexed, and here they are just growing massively. That's mental. Was not expecting that at all. Good job, Limovitia. Solid work. Kimarcus is dead. Unfortunate. So, new religious guy, that's your job. I think you need some free hands. Durati are a little bit scorned right now as well. Yeah, two armies of 9k horse archers. Just really good. And then 16 of my own. Not bad generals either. Improved office. Gained two marshal on my bodyguard. For 15 political influence. Sounds like a sweet deal. See, I've got a lot of money, but I also don't want to build any buildings because, I mean, I don't need them. I'm going to be up and moving soon enough. How much does it cost right now? 539. Is that everywhere 539? Yes. So I've got 24 cities. Let's do some maths. It's never a good idea to do it, but whatever. So it's 5.49 times 24. It's 131 stability right now, which I clearly can't do. Gain 5 stability. Yes. That's a good price. So we need to make it even cheaper to do it. Even cheaper to start migrating. Maybe like, I don't know what the math is. Negative 67 centralization means negative 5.31. Ah, wait, no, because it's the base cost, and then negative centralization is half of your negative centralization. Something like that? I don't know. Close enough. So, I wonder, is Limovitia going to get its revenge on Aulbergia? Oh, Lurkia, something like that. Probably, eventually. Ooh, you're up to 10. You'll go up to 10 soon enough. Nice. Yeah, I think negative 50% on the base is probably going to be a good idea. Siluvia wants an alliance. You know what? That sounds like a good alliance. I'll take it. 20 cohorts. Not bad. Not bad at all. Not bad. Oh, and he's at war again. Did you? Oh, hello. The Venetians have attacked him. Yeah, now you're fucked, mate. You're absolutely boned. And this is why you need to be very careful going over the limit. Because if you do it, you will get this happen to you. And probably before the war is over, someone else is going to attack him as well. New High Priest, you can do that job. Two more tribesmen. Yeah, I wonder why they're trying to flee from Lemovitzia. Are any of these places Volcae, actually? No. You don't even have any Volcae. Maybe the last two Volcae run away. Ran away, even. You're starving, so perhaps we will move you elsewhere. Move from Uxulodunum. There you go, just to stop you starving without me having to do much else. Everyone's happy again. Yeah, he's getting fully annexed. Maybe. And then, if you take all of the land, then you get fully annexed next. Wait, it was the Venetians that declared the war, or Veneto. Where is Veneto? I know there is a Veneto there. Are you the one that attacked him? You are. What? What is this? This is kind of insane. Why would you be the ones to be the war leader? I don't get it. And Lingonia have occupied a city. How? I guess Boy is on Lemovitzian side? Oh, I know what it is. Boy are in a defensive league with Lingonia. No, wrong one. Were they guaranteed, perhaps? No idea. Yeah, no, I have no idea. Either way, I don't think there's any coming back from Lemovitzia now. Tis all over. Gain some loyalty on this guy. I don't really care about either of those people. But gain 10 stability sounds real nice. So, yes. I think before we lose a bunch of it, I'm going to start migrating. Oh, 10k. And I think we don't have to pay for these at all either, which is real nice. I will migrate here. I'm going to migrate everyone that doesn't have a border with anyone else, so nobody can take it. No sea tiles either. You've got a sea tile, you don't. This can be done as well. Let's let the stability come back. These guys can all stay exactly where they are. And we're gonna start moving over here soon enough. I wonder, can I go through other people's land? Yes, I can, thankfully. That helps a lot. Yeah, I don't have to pay for these units either, which is really handy. That was one of the recent changes. We are not getting anything. There we go. Stab two pigs for 130. And that's going to get our stability back up real quick. Then when we get to about 60, we'll start migrating again. And eventually we'll just migrate everyone at once. And fuck off over here. And all this shit can, you know, just deal with it, really. Ooh, we're getting a bit of attrition. I guess it's cold. There we go. You've only got, what, these left. This city, are you under siege? Negative 0.3, yeah. So as soon as this falls, it's all over. I wonder what's going to happen to him. I mean, it could be that Aulercius takes a bunch of land, but I don't know. Because it's Veneto's war, somehow. Need a new magistrate. You can have that job. We'll have manpower recovery speed. Can merge all of our dudes. I don't want to merge everyone. Yeah, I think that's fine. So I don't want them to take attrition going over. Peace! Wait, there's peace. Who did you peace out? Someone, but not everyone. I mean, Lemovitz is also attacking Aulercia and doing reasonably well. Lose 10 political influence for some popularity. You know what? That's okay. Popularity is good. You guys can join up together and you guys can join up together. Or maybe not. I mean, you're basically attrition weight negative 50%, so I'm not sure really why we're having a bit of a problem here. You, again, need to be released and probably bribed as well. And get armies roughly this size so they don't take attrition as they march away. Trade hub developing. Ooh, yes! More Volcay. I like it. Very nice indeed. 55 now. Let's get another few migrants. And you can join up with this one. Pirates. Nay, nay, nay. It's going to be tough actually bringing my regular army over. I'm not sure how I'm going to do that. Unless I declare war on someone and then try and peace out very quickly, black flag myself and march over my black flagged units. That might be possible. Maybe. Let's actually have a test, right? We are friends with you. We have military access. So let's march in. What happens if I cancel military access? They're my subjects, of course. Do we have access through you? No, we don't. Let's get it. March into your territory. Now, cancel probably won't be able to because I've got a dude there. Oh, no, I don't. Am I black flagged? Yes, I... Oh, that was super easy. That is the easiest black flag in any of the Paradox games, by far. Well, that, with that sorted, with that hurdle out of the way, I'm going to take a short break here. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you did, feel free to click the like button. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye for now.